In this video, I'm going to show you how to extract audio from a DVD using the VLC Media Player. First, you'll need to download and install VLC from the videolan.org site. Then, insert your DVD or CD into your computer's DVD or CD-ROM player. Open VLC Media Player and click on the Media tab. Scroll down and select Convert or Save to open the Open Media window. You can also use the shortcut keys Ctrl and R to open the Open Media window. In the Open Media window, click on the Disk tab. Then select the appropriate media, DVD, Blu-ray, Audio CD, or SVCD, the Super Video Compact Disc, or VCD. The main differences between these types of media is how much data they can hold. CDs, SVCDs, and VCDs max at about 700 megabytes of data. DVDs hold a maximum of 8.5 gigabytes of data, and a standard Blu-ray will hold 25 gigabytes of data. I'm converting audio from a DVD, so I select DVD. Then check the No Disk Menu checkbox. This will make sure that VLC skips the disk menu and converts the contents of the drive. If you don't check this box, VLC will only convert the contents of the disk menu. If you have more than one DVD or CD-ROM drive, make sure the appropriate one that has the DVD is selected as the disk device. The title, chapter, audio track options enable you to only convert a specific part of the DVD. If you are converting the whole DVD, leave them at their default values. But I'll cover these options in the FAQ section at the end of this video. Click on the Convert or Save button to open the Convert window. In this window, you only need to set the profile and name your destination file. To extract the audio from a DVD as an MP3 file, you need to set the profile as Audio MP3. Click on the Profile drop-down menu and scroll down and select the Audio MP3 profile. To set the destination folder and file name, click on Browse and navigate to the folder where you want to save the file. Type in the file name. I want to name my file as Audio from DVD. Then click Save. That takes you back to the Convert window. Press Start to start extracting audio from your DVD. It takes about 5 minutes to extract the audio from an hour-long DVD. And that's it. Let me answer some frequently asked questions. When I get to the end of my conversion, VLC asks me to overwrite the existing file. What can I do? This is caused by setting your playback to loop. To solve this issue, exit VLC, open it up again, and uncheck the loop button. Then restart the conversion process. I have ripped all the songs and they're in one file. Can I convert individual songs? Yes, you can, but it's easier to convert the whole DVD. You'll get one audio file, then use Audacity to split the files into individual songs. I have created a short how-to video on splitting a file in Audacity. I'll post a link in the description below. How do I convert only a section of the DVD? You can use the title, chapter, start and end time positions to only convert a certain section of your DVD. In the Open Media window, you can access the start and end times by clicking the Show More Options checkbox. So, if I only want to convert audio from a certain section, let's say title 2, chapter 4, I can set the title and the chapter. I'll set the title and the start and end times. Let me show you how you can figure out the titles, chapters, and durations in your DVD. I'll click on the Convert drop-down menu and select Play to play my DVD. Then press the spacebar to pause the DVD. Hover over the video and right-click with my mouse. Let's scroll down to Audio, and you can see that this DVD only has one audio track. If your DVD has audio with multiple languages, you'll find them here. and you can define which audio track you want to extract from the DVD. We'll look at this option in a little while. If we scroll down to playback, we can see that this DVD has 8 titles. We are playing title 2, which has 6 chapters. We're in chapter 1 right now, but you can go to any chapter by selecting it. Now, if you want to extract audio from a set section in this title, let's say from here to here, all you need to do is note the start time and the end time. So from 14 minutes to 20 minutes, for instance. Let's head back to the convert menu, and you have set the title to 2 and the chapter to 0 because you want to set the start and end times of your clip. We'll set our start time to be 14 minutes, click on the minutes and use the up arrow to increase them to 14 or type in 14, and then set 20 minutes as the end time. If your DVD has multiple languages, you can set the audio track you wish to convert here. Then set the profile and destination folder. I've converted my DVD, but my audio is garbled. What can I do? This is a question I get a lot, and there are a number of reasons as to why your audio output is garbled. First, make sure that your VLC can play the whole DVD. If you have a section of your DVD that's unplayable, the conversion process will not complete and you have garbled audio. If VLC can play the whole DVD without issues, then try and play the extracted audio with VLC. If the audio plays on VLC but not on other devices, there could be compatibility issues. For instance, some devices do not support 5.1 surround sound. If your DVD has surround sound, you may need to convert it to stereo. To do that, you need to edit the audio MP3 profile, click on the gear icon, then click on the audio codec tab. Make sure the keep original audio track is not selected. Select the MPEG audio codec. This is a widely supported codec. Set the bitrate to 192. This is a bitrate that gives you excellent sound compression. Set your channels to 2 and use the 44,100 Hz sampling rate. Click on save and the extracted audio from your DVD will be stereo and compatible with most devices. Can I extract WAV audio? Yes, use the CD profile to extract .WAV audio. Can I extract 5.1 surround sound? Yes, you can. Click on the gear icon to edit the MP3 profile and click on the audio codec tab and make sure that you check the keep original audio track checkbox. Can I extract only the vocals? If your DVD has the vocals in a separate channel, yes, you can. Check the keep original audio track and then import the extracted audio into a software that supports multiple channels, for instance, Adobe Audition, and then convert the channels to mono and save the vocal channel. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section below. Have a great day.